Welcome back. Didn't quite realize the timing on these, on what I was doing, so I kind of ran over. So this is actually a follow-up to some of the earlier ones. This is 30 by 41 sheet, 7-ups. It's a 1970s cop film with a epic chase scene, car chase scene that just has a great ending to the chase scene itself. As I mentioned earlier, a lot of these 30-40s, I got them at a great price, and a lot of time, they're not all horror, but I got them because sometimes the artwork was really outstanding. From the guy that did the Guns of Navarone, Force 10 of Navarone, Alistair McLean's When 8 Bells Toll, and my God, look at that artwork. And when I got this thing here for less than what it would cost for a muffin at the donut shop, it was worth it. And here you go, Fright Fiends. Sword in the Stone from Walt Disney. This was a gift for Teresa, who is a big Disney fan and Winnie the Pooh fan as well. She's a big fan of Eeyore. And there he is, floating around, wondering, what the hell? Guys, help. Guys, what's going on? Yeah. Nothing like friends. Yeah. What's up with Pooh? He's not even wearing clothes. Of course, the original Pooh didn't, the classic Poohs. Here's another one that design-wise I just thought was outstanding, and this one is Twist of Sand. Artwork is just great. You know, you got the knife fight going on in front of the sun, you've got all sorts of weapons and ships in the background, and some girl ogling a bunch of gold coins and diamonds and victims, and it all comes down. I kind of like how it just pours right into the negative space of the white. I've actually never seen this film, but I will keep my eye out for it eventually if it ever pops up, because I've got Richard Johnson in it. Another really beautiful piece. This one is Bite the Bullet with Gene Hackman, James Coburn, Candice Bergen. And when you see a nice train shot in the background, I kind of like things like trains. And not in the Sheldon Cooper way of liking trains. I just kind of like trains and artwork, especially when it's really dramatic. Runaway Train, the European one is just outstanding. Artwork, I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. Fortunately, I don't have enough wall in my life to, I think that might be it. Let's pull that one off. Alright, so I guess that's it for this one here. I might as well, you know what, I might as well throw this out too. Show you this. Sorry about that. This is the tie poster for the remake of the Wolfman. I don't think I'm getting a great shot of that. He's got this great shot of the Wolfman here. And the reason I gravitated towards this poster is because it actually has the Wolfman on it. I mean, far be it for me to actually expect the Wolfman to be on the poster for the Wolfman, but in the United States, we are so star-driven that they have to have the floating heads of the stars from the movie, so that's the problem with that, and they had Emily Blunt and Del Toro and Hopkins. And while I'm here, I got time, I'm going to show you a couple of window inserts, Dayville type of style. This one is, Lady Kung Fu.
She's a lethal lady of Kung Fu.
I like how she's got the hair whip going on and taking out this clown in the back, you know? It's kind of cool. Awesome movie poster. Kind of a crappy film. The Keep. They were all drawn to The Keep. Is you recognize that one, I'm sure. Stephen King's Firestarter. And there are one more lying around here. Oh. Flip it over there, sweetheart. Curtains.
Curtain, someone is waiting, something is watching.
But I always like the little doll coming out from the curtain with a creepy guy head at the top. I just thought that was really outstanding artwork, so I had to get one of these. So that's that one there. And as a bonus, we'll throw this in because it's one of my wife's favorite films.
Ready?
Despicable Me. This is one of various one sheets that they did. Sorry for the Blair Witch-like shaky camera work, but I'm trying to keep these folder things. Super Bad, Super Dad. Really a cute, warm film.
Love the Minions.
Yeah, she's a big Minion fan. You can see that was actually a gift from a friend of ours at the wedding. That's a theater promo piece. And later they put it with a Walmart exclusive, but we actually have a number of Despicable Me pieces around here that will eventually get cataloged. So that is our video. Hopefully, you haven't run off and check out Kitties on Treadmill videos or anything like that, but I can't blame you if you did. Thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned for more of my overly obsessive movie poster collection. Bye-bye.